Hello and welcome back to another episode of MFBE. So today we're gonna take on the final stage of Dark Vision. So this stage contains 2 mini boss and 1 final boss. The first mini boss is Kokuril. So this is a magical domain of ice and light. So we use magic team here and does a light damage. The first unit that we take here is Cyrus. So he here has a killer buffer. We're gonna use Draconic Distraction here for a 100% dragon killer buff. The second unit is Ares, so she here has a light magic chainer, so she's gonna chain with Huja. Her best form gonna gear on her magic damage and magic dragon killer. Ibarra here has a limit burst finisher, so she's gonna use her limit in dark element. So I use Starlight Elena guard here because we need extra 50% limit burst damage. And she gear for a dragon killer and limit burst damage. Another unit is Master Myson. He is a 100% physical evasion and provoke tank. And he gonna copy dragon killer for us. Another thing here is he needs to stand on Anima because we need to use this 70% dark elemental resistance buff. Kuja gonna be a magic chainer. He gonna chain light damage with Aerith. And more than that, he gonna use his fire ability to buff 75% fire resistance for team. Starlight Irina gonna be a finisher here. We gonna use her in brave form. So she's gonna gear for attack magic and physical dragon killer. Let's go into the fight. Boss buff itself with a barrier, but don't worry, we're gonna use Elena to dispel that. We start with Syrah, so he's gonna use his dragon killer and his cooldown to buff magic. Aerith don't have anything to do here, so she gonna guard. Ibarra gonna use her cooldown to break the spirit. Starlight Irina gonna imbue herself with light element and use her cooldown to buff attack magic and dispel the boss. Huja gonna triple cast his fire resistance, soul splitter and crusade. Mastermind gonna use enchant by darkness to buff 70% dark elemental resistance. Because we immune to fire and dark element, physical and magical attack unable to hurt us. Operative Silas gonna use his magna to amplify his damage. Aerith gonna shift into her breath form, prepare for her burst next turn with her cooldown and magna stability. Ibarra gonna shift because we are gonna buff her magic and decrease dark resistance. Starlight Irina gonna shift into her bear form and use her limit. Huja gonna use Overture limit to fill his limit gauge. Mastermind gonna copy killer and elemental using critical on Silas and elemental on Elena. Alright, as you can see here, boss decrease your elemental resistance. If you want to go beyond this turn, you need more elemental resistance than this. But I'm gonna kill boss in this turn. Silas gonna triple cast his bolting style, so he's gonna chain with Thorn. Mastermind Thorn also triple cast his bolting style chain. Aerith gonna quad cast her light magic chaining. Kuja also do a quad cast with Holy Symphony, Angelic Advance and Crusade. Ibarra gonna use her limit burst. Starlight Irina gonna triple cast her finishing move. We send Bolting Strike first, followed by Chaos Wave Awaken and the rest. Hopefully I able to tap. Only 1.4. Alright, let's move to the second stage. Alright, for stage 2, this is a physical domain of fire and lightning. Boss is a spirit type monster. There are two things that you need to do here is all members need a paralyze resistance because boss can paralyze you. The second is you need 30% or more for water and ice resistance. The first unit is Regina, so she here gonna buff Spirit Killer for us, and her damage is not that important, so you can gear her with anything. We're gonna use Fairy Killer on turn 2, and on turn 1 we're gonna use Bar Wataka here, so she needs to stand on Leviathan. Second unit is Vaan, so Vaan gonna be a breaker for us, and he gonna be an AR channel on burst turn because he unable to dual cast that you need to dual wield equip on him. Mastermindson gonna be an 100% evasion and provoke tank. He also do a copy killer and chain AR for us. Tifa gonna be a limit burst finisher, but because of this team unable to imbue fire, you need Craftsman Secret Book to do a fire imbue on turn 1. In her shift form, you can focus on her attack, limit burst damage, and spirit killer. Cloud gonna be another limit burst finisher here, so we're gonna use him in this form only. So our gear is focused on his physical damage. Virion also another limit burst finisher here. In his normal form, you can gear him anything, but in his breath form, we need high attack, limit burst damage, and spirit killer. Alright, let's go. Another thing that I forget to mention that Mastermindson needs to stand on Carbuncle because we need Bar Pisaka on him. We start with Regina with Bar Wataka, and Mastermindson with Bar Pisaka. Vaan gonna dual cast his perfect dispel and jet parry. Tifa gonna imbue fire to herself. Cloud gonna do a Stardust Ray Chain to fill his limit gauge. Virion also do his Stardust Ray Chain to fill his limit gauge too. Alright, on turn 2, Regina gonna start with her Spirit Killer buff. Vaan gonna use his limit burst to break and Imperial 130% fire element. Tifa gonna shift and use her Grand Disability to do a limit burst damage buff. Cloud gonna do his cooldown and limit burst damage buff. Virion also shift and use hit cooldown to buff attack. Mastermindson gonna copy killer and elemental. We gonna use critical on Regina and elemental on Tifa. As long as you have 100% ice and water resistance, you take no damage from Carbuncle. Even that damage is a physical one. Regina gonna guard here. Vaan gonna use his Luminescence for AR chaining. Also, Mastermindson gonna use Dual Cast to Dual Cast his AR chaining move. Tifa gonna use her Limit Burst. Cloud and Virion also use their Limit Burst too. cloud did not break the chain, but the final hit is missing. Really? 2 billion? Alright, I'm gonna do again for variation rolling. Alright, move to the final stage. Okay, for the final stage, Dark Alexander. So this stage, you're able to use physical unit or magical unit, and able to use all element because Alexander has 60% all elemental resistance. There are 2 things that important that you need to know here. First, the physical damage dealer need to have blind resistance because Alexander able to blind you in a fight. Second is all units need at least 80% or more for light and dark resistance. Sakura gonna be your first unit here, so she need 80% or more in light and dark resistance. And she gonna use her Magnus ability, Candy Fist. So this ability able to buff you 100% in light and dark resistance. Also her breath form need 80% or more for dark and light resistance too, because we gonna use her to imbue dark elemental to the rest of the party. Her gear is focus on magic and magic 2 double hand. Yoshihiro gonna be 100% evasion and provoke tank, and hit gear is pretty much focus on that and light and dark resistance. So he gonna do his job in his breath form. So you don't need to gear him on breath form because we gonna use this form in the final turn, and we gonna use him to buff a limit burst damage and also machine killer. Starlight Illina gonna be a chainer here, so she need 80% or more light and dark resistance to, and we gonna use her in this form only, so you need to gear her full damage and full resistance here. Another unit is Tifa, so she gonna be a limit burst finisher here, and she need elemental resistance in this form only, and we gonna use her as a defense breaker here with her normal form limit burst. For her breath form, we're gonna use her as damage dealer, so you don't need any elemental resistance here, just gear for full damage and killer. Firion also the same thing as Tifa, so his normal form need an elemental resistance as much as you can, and his breath form need full damage with limit burst damage. Ibarra also be a limit burst finisher here, so we use Starlight Elena card here because of an extra 50% limit burst damage. Her normal form need light and dark resistance, but her breath form don't need that. Alright, let's go into the fight. Alexander will buff itself for physical mitigation and magic mitigation, so you unable to deal damage until turn 4. Sakura gonna use Candy Feet here for 100% light and dark resistance. The rest gonna chain, so we gonna do Stardust Ray chain for Tifa and Firion and Starlight Elena. Ibarra and Yoshihiro gonna do both things Starlight chain, so we gonna clear 100 chain score first. As you can see here, Alexander does Blyga and Light and Dark Ruin. If you don't have Blind Protection, your physical unit get Blind here. For Light and Dark Ruin, it decreases your elemental resistance for 80%. Tifa gonna use her Limit Burst to decrease boss defense. Ibarra gonna use her cooldown to decrease spirit for 80%. Sakura gonna shift into her breath form and use her imbue to imbue herself, Elena and Tifa. Elena gonna use her limit burst here to amplify her skill. Yoshi and Firion don't have anything to do here, so you can do anything with them. Alright, on turn 3, Sakura gonna finish her job, so she gonna imbue the final one. That period. And she gonna decrease 120% dark resistance with her Chaos Wave Awakened Shining move. Tifa gonna buff her attack with Hot and Fever and fill her limit gauge for next turn burst. Fillion gonna do his cooldown and grant this to buff his attack. Ibarra will do her cooldown to buff her magic. Yoshi also don't have anything to do here, so I'm use a cooldown on him. Elena will use her cooldown to buff attack and magic. Alright, this is the burst turn, so we start with Grimlord Sakura, so she gonna triple cast her Boxing Strike alongside with Starlight Illina. Yoshi gonna shift into his breath form and triple cast, so we gonna cast Machine Killer, limit burst damage buff and attack and magic buff. Tifa gonna use her limit burst in her breath form. Fillion also shift into his breath form and use his limit burst. Ibarra also shift into her breath form and use her limit burst. Alright, send Ibarra and Fillion first because their limit bird have a long animation. Don't forget that we use triple cast both inside, it's pretty quick here. Okay, that's fine. 1.6 billion. Thanks for watching and bye.